Hello all. I hope you're enjoying this learning experience. Welcome to Unit 4. In Unit 3, we illustrated the history of open educational resources, taking notes of the actors and the triggers. In this unit, we are going to focus on OER declarations and action plan. In June 2012, UNESCO and the Commonwealth of Learning held a World OER Congress in Paris. At this point, the Open Educational Resources Movement was a decade old. The Congress formally adopted a 10-point declaration calling on states to realize the benefits of open education. The declaration was influenced by Article 26 of the United Nations Universal Declaration on Human Rights, which states that everyone has the right to education, and Article 13.1 of the International Covenant on Economic, Social and Cultural Rights, which recognizes the right of everyone to education. The declaration asserts that government and states, within their capacities, should foster awareness and use of open educational resources, facilitate enabling environment for use of ICT, reinforce the development of strategies and policies on OER, promote the understanding and use of open licensing frameworks, support capacity building for the sustainable development of quality learning material, foster strategic alliance for open educational resources, encourage the development and adaptation of OER in a variety of languages and cultural contexts, encourage research on OER, facilitate finding, retrieving, and sharing of OER, and lastly, encourage the open licensing of educational materials produced with public funds. Now, let us look at OER Action Plan, famously known as the Ljubljana OER Action Plan. This is a product of 6 regional consultative meetings. It presents 41 recommended actions geared towards building knowledge societies to achieve the 2030 Sustainable Development Goal 4 on quality and lifelong learning. The action plan provides recommendations to stakeholders in 5 strategic areas. 1. Building the capacity of users to find, reuse, create and share open educational resources. 2. Language and cultural issues. 3. Ensure inclusive and equitable access to quality open educational resources. 4. Developing sustainable models. 5. Developing supportive policy environment. Thank you for your time. See you soon.